Aikido is quite effective in incapacitating street bullies and arrogant individuals. However, in this video, we will see how effective Aikido is when facing a professional MMA fighter. Some techniques in Aikido are known to be very painful. However, in MMA fights, fighters' hands are wrapped and taped. Despite this, fighters like Anderson Silva have trained in Aikido and have tried to incorporate its techniques into fights within the octagon. The following fighter also demonstrated that gloves are not an obstacle to performing Aikido locking techniques. He managed to make his opponent fall using a perfectly executed wrist lock technique. Not just once, this Aikido practitioner was able to make his opponent fall repeatedly and dominate the fight with his lethal Aikido techniques.
But once it was...
This is an example of how Aikido can be effectively used in an MMA fight. Aikido itself is a Japanese martial art developed in the early 20th century by Morihei Ueshiba. Aikido focuses on harmonizing with the opponent's energy rather than confronting it directly. Aikido techniques involve circular movements that redirect the opponent's force, using their momentum against them. Aikido practitioners usually avoid direct confrontation, preferring to channel attacks into controlled movements. Aikido techniques emphasize efficiency, utilizing minimal physical strength by applying joint locks, throws, and precise strikes. Combat in Aikido often involves manipulating the attacker's joints, such as the wrists, elbows, or shoulders, to incapacitate or unbalance them. To defend, practitioners frequently deflect attacks by blending with incoming force and redirecting it through circular movements. This technique focuses on disrupting the opponent's balance, making them vulnerable to being subdued. Overall, Aikido's philosophy of blending, circular movements, and minimal force sets it apart as a martial art centered on harmony and effective self-defense. Aikido techniques can also be adapted to various fighting situations, making them versatile for different types of opponents and arenas. For instance, in a match between a one-handed Aikido master and a professional MMA fighter, the Aikido master managed to challenge the MMA fighter significantly, even with just one hand. The Aikido master was able to hold his own when they engaged in a clinch. He even managed to take the MMA fighter to the ground. Not stopping there, the Aikido master continued to dominate even during ground combat.
Yosh!
Next, there was an arrogant Aikido practitioner who claimed that his martial art was superior to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. He then challenged an MMA fighter with a BJJ background to a match. However, what happened in the arena was completely opposite to his big talk. Throughout the fight, he only tried to evade the powerful attacks of the MMA fighter and never once launched an attack. The MMA fighter taught him a valuable lesson with a hard slam to the floor that left him in significant pain. Continuing with the story of an MMA fighter with a BJJ background versus an Aikido practitioner, This time, the MMA fighter had a larger and more muscular physique. They were engaged in a clinch position for a long time before the MMA fighter finally managed to take down the Aikido master with his immense strength. However, this did not have a significant impact on the Aikido master. While under pressure in the ground fight, he executed a neck lock that forced the MMA fighter to submit. Let's move to an outdoor arena where two overweight fighters are competing. The Aikido fighter, wearing white pants, was much older than the MMA fighter. This was evident in their fight, where the MMA fighter dominated with his powerful punches. The MMA fighter took only 30 seconds to win the fight by forcing the Aikido master to the ground. Lastly, there was a Japanese Aikido fighter facing an intimidating-looking MMA fighter. Hey! However, the MMA fighter's intimidating appearance did not match his fighting abilities. From the start of the match, the MMA fighter was pressured to the edge of the ring. He could not break free from the tight hold of the Aikido master. Eventually, he was thrown onto the canvas, and they engaged in ground combat. The Aikido practitioner did not give him any chance. The MMA fighter ultimately submitted after being unable to withstand the extremely painful Aikido lock. Aikido practitioners and enthusiasts around the world owe a great deal of gratitude and respect to Steven Seagal, as he is one of the individuals who popularized this Japanese martial art. Seagal's first job was as a dishwasher at a restaurant called the Wagon Wheel. Noticing his quick movements, a Japanese Shotokan karate expert who was the cook at the restaurant decided to give him basic karate training. This marked the beginning of Seagal's long martial arts journey. In 1964, he began studying Aikido under the guidance of Harry Kiyoshi Ishisaka. In his late teens, Seagal moved to Japan with his father, who was visiting the country for military reasons, and they decided to stay there permanently. Not long after, Seagal earned a 7th degree black belt and the title of Shihan in Aikido. This Japanese term is used in various martial arts to honor senior martial arts practitioners. Subsequently, Seagal became the first foreigner in Japan to successfully run an Aikido dojo.